what's the best way to download and manage apps if you're using a Mac computer? Well, most people probably use Apple's App Store. Add your Apple ID and everything is conveniently in the same place and updated with the click of a button. But there are big privacy costs to this. Adding an Apple ID to your computer means that all of your activity can be easily tied together and you can be profiled based on that activity. This is the third video in our Mac privacy series. Previously, we explained how much data Apple collects about its users and that if you want meaningful privacy, then you should try Linux. But if you're not ready to make the switch, there are at least ways that you can improve the privacy of your Mac. In this video, I'll explain the downsides of using the Apple App Store on your Mac computer and talk about Homebrew, an alternative app store that you can use that doesn't harvest your data and still allows you to manage all of your apps in one place. I'll explain the privacy benefits, give you a tutorial on how to install it, and then teach you how to use it. Let's start with talking about the Apple ID and the App Store. On an Apple iPhone, you need to use both of these in order to install apps, although a recent audit in the EU has forced Apple to allow sideloading of apps. On a computer, you don't need to use the App Store to download apps, which means that you don't ever need to add an Apple ID to the device. In fact, one of the most important things you can do for privacy is to never associate an Apple ID with the device. Unfortunately, Apple makes it a little tricky to opt out. When you first buy your device, the store will ask you for your Apple ID when checking out. You should tell them that you don't have one. Then, when you first set up your computer, it will prompt you to add an Apple ID, and it's not immediately clear how to skip past this step. The Continue button is grayed out unless you fill in your ID. What you might have missed is in the bottom left corner, it says Set Up Later. Click that. And now they have barriers to downloading software outside of the App Store. Gatekeeper, which is a macOS security feature that controls which apps are allowed to run on your Mac, by default only allows apps from the App Store or from developers that Apple has verified. And if you want to allow downloads from elsewhere, you have to first turn off Gatekeeper's strict enforcement using command line, and then go back into your settings and select the option to allow apps from anywhere. They really want all your downloads to go through them. This enables them to build a permanent record of your downloads and updates through the App Store, and a detailed profile of your interests, habits, and activities. Now, the benefits of using the App Store is that it makes it super convenient to manage all of your apps. For example, you can update everything with a single button. If instead you've downloaded every app separately from each website, updating can be messy. You have to open every app manually and update it manually. You can always set them to auto-update, but you might not want these apps to be able to connect to the internet at all times and ping servers without you knowing in order to check for updates. In fact, I use a firewall software, Little Snitch, to block my apps from unnecessarily talking to the internet, which makes auto-updates even harder. It's easy to forget to check every app and to remember to turn your firewall back on afterwards. This is where Homebrew comes in handy, by providing the convenience of the App Store without all the tracking. Homebrew is a package manager for macOS and Linux. A package manager is similar to an App Store in many ways. It's like a trusted hub where you can easily find, install, and update apps in one place. Homebrew is a well-known open source package manager, but it's going to look quite different from the App Stores that you're used to. First, there's no visual store, or GUI, which stands for Graphical User Interface. Instead, you use the command line in Terminal to use it. Second, you can't buy anything in the store. All the software is free. Some of the available apps have paid upgrade features, but Homebrew itself has no ability to collect payments. And third, you don't need any account to access it. There's no hidden tracking and no ads. There are three main benefits, in my opinion, of using Homebrew to install install and manage apps instead of downloading them directly from websites. First is the convenience factor. Instead of visiting dozens of websites to find, install, or update apps, Homebrew gives you super easy commands to automate this process, and you can use it without handing over telemetry about everything you're doing. The second benefit is safety. There are ways in which Homebrew can help decrease the risk of installing fake or malicious software. When you download apps manually, there's always the chance that you've accidentally spelt the URL wrong or landed on a fake website through a phishing link. Homebrew pulls apps from official verified sources, and it automatically checks the integrity of every file. Generally, open source repos include a checksum of the file on their website, which is basically a hash of the exact file. The checksum of what you downloaded should be identical to the checksum the app has provided. Homebrew verifies that they match to make sure that what you're downloading hasn't been changed or tampered with, or that you're not downloading an outdated or unsafe version of the app. Now, you could verify the checksum manually yourself, and also double and triple check every URL you visit, but Homebrew makes all of this a lot simpler by doing it for you. Their code is also watched over by a large community, and they log every change to the software publicly. So while no system is 100% safe and someone could compromise Homebrew itself, it's a highly reputable and highly regarded tool in the open source community. There's also a third benefit to using Homebrew. The software is also compatible with Linux, so if you ever decide to switch operating systems down the line, Homebrew is a great way to make the transition easier and get comfortable with some of the tools that you'll probably be using on Linux too. In all, Homebrew is a convenient way to manage apps without giving up privacy, with added security benefits and the bonus of being a stepping stone to a more privacy-friendly operating system. Now let's go over how to install Homebrew on your computer. First, go to your Utilities folder and open Terminal. Now open your browser and go to brew.sh, and on the landing page, you'll see a command. Click Copy. Paste this command into Terminal. Don't try to retype it manually because any minor error will break the command and might do unintended things. Because many of you might be brand new to command line, I'll go through each part of this command slowly so that you understand what you're doing. You don't need to know this. Copy and pasting works fine, but I liked understanding what I was typing when I first started using Homebrew. If you don't really care, feel free to skip ahead to the rest of the tutorial. The command starts with a /. In Unix-based systems like macOS and Linux, a single /- represents the root directory, which is the very top level of your file system. It also acts as a separator between folders in a file path. /bin/bash says go to the root folder, then to the bin folder, and run the program called bash that's located there. Next is -c. This is a flag for the bash program. It tells bash, run the following string in quotation marks as a command. In quotation marks, we have curl, which is a tool that downloads things from the internet. -f simply means that if the program fails to connect, it should fail silently, i.e. don't print a scary error message. The first -s stands for silent mode, which means don't print a bunch of progress text while downloading. The capital S instructs the program to show an error only if something goes wrong. -l tells the program to follow redirects if the file moves to a different place online. FSSL is a combination that is commonly used in scripts to fetch a file cleanly and quietly without cluttering the terminal. And then the URL shows the location of a small text file called install.sh that contains the official Homebrew installer instructions. So you're simply instructing your computer to download the Homebrew installer from the URL provided, which is the Homebrew's official GitHub page. The dollar and parenthesis is called command substitution. It means run the stuff in brackets first and then use its output as the input for the surrounding command. So in this case, we run the curl command, which fetches a script from the internet, and once the script is downloaded, its contents will replace the entire dollar parenthesis block, and the program bash will execute it like it was typed out directly. In plain English, download the Homebrew install script from GitHub and run it using bash. Again, you don't need to understand what all of this stuff means. You could simply copy and paste it into your terminal and then press enter. Then follow the prompts. First, it will ask for your password. You'll notice that when you type your password into terminal, it won't show any dots or characters. That's normal. Press enter when done and Homebrew will start the installation. You may be asked to add another command to add Homebrew to your path. Highlight the command that you're given in Terminal, copy it, and then paste that command into Terminal to run it and press enter. And that's it, Homebrew is ready to go. To verify your installation, type brew space dash dash version. If you see a version number, Homebrew is installed. Now that you have Homebrew installed, let's explain how to use it. The first thing you can do is turn off analytics. Type brew space analytics space off. Then you'll probably want to know which apps you can install via Homebrew. You can browse all the available apps by going to formulae.brew.sh. There are two types of apps that you can install. Ones that run just in the command line, like FFmpeg and YouTube DLP, and then there are full Mac apps that have a user interface like Brave Browser, LibreOffice, Audacity, Bitwarden, VLC, and more. To install an app, type brew space install space app name. Then to see a list of all the apps that you've installed, type brew space list. To update your apps, first type brew space update to refresh your app list, then type brew space upgrade to install the updates. Some macOS apps auto-update, so Homebrew sometimes presumes that they don't need to be managed and skips them, even if the version is old. To force these upgrades, including any potentially outdated casks, use brew space upgrade space dash dash greedy. You can find a full list of all the commands on the Homebrew website. To understand this page, the main headings like alias, analytics, auto-remove, etc. are the commands. Underneath each one, you'll see different flags or options that you can add to that command. One important thing to note, something like cleanup might be its own command, or it might be a flag used with a different command, so pay close attention to whether it has dashes in front of it. To clean up any unnecessary cached files, you'd type brew space cleanup space dash s. Sometimes you'll see two options next to each other, one with a single dash and the other with two dashes, like dash s and dash dash scrub. These are aliases, meaning they do the same thing. The single dash version is just a shortcut for the longer, more descriptive one. Don't be overwhelmed with all these commands. The handful that we've covered here includes basically all the commands you actually need in day-to-day use. Now, to manage my apps and keep them updated, once a week I'll briefly turn off Little Snitch, then I'll paste the following into Terminal. It takes a few seconds and all my apps are up to date. Then I turn Little Snitch back on and go about my day. In his book Extreme Privacy, Michael Basil has a program that you can download that you can just click on to run, and you don't have to type anything into Terminal at all, and it includes even more advanced settings for keeping your system clean and up to date. He also has a script that you can run for uninstalling any apps from Brew and removing any trace of the app from your system. Command line can seem daunting if you're not used to it, but Homebrew is a really great way to get started if you want to try it out. There are really just a few commands that you need to use, so it's perfect for getting your feet wet. Privacy doesn't have to be overwhelming. You can take one step at a time, try out new tools, keep what works and let go of what doesn't, and keep experimenting. And with Homebrew, you'll reclaim the convenience of an app store without all the surveillance, without needing an Apple ID, and without building a permanent record. NBTV is a project of the Ludlow Institute, a non-profit research and media institute that educates people about how to reclaim ownership of their digital lives. Help us shift culture around privacy. Visit ludlowinstitute.org/donate to support our mission. And also check out our merch shop for cool clothes that can support the mission as well.
Bottoms up, let's get brewing. It's just water. I didn't have any beer in the fridge.